Hi, I'm Rick Emerson, and welcome back to Outlook Portland on Northwest 32 TV. Portland has been my home for 10 years now, and all the time that I've lived in Portland, it always continues to surprise me. Men on bikes in cow outfits, fire dancers in graveyards, a band of minstrels in Renaissance attire playing at 3 in the morning, pirates roaming the streets, hula hooping under streetlights in the wee hours with random strangers. I never did figure out where the rest of those hula hoops came from. But my best memories of Portland are of snow. Where else can a police officer come up to you saying, "What are you doing?" I say, "Well, riding down this hill on a couch we found attached to snowboards." The cop says, "Can I watch?" and then takes a picture with his cell phone. Portland has a touch of magic and irreverence that has captured me and kept me here permanently. And that's by Amy Heigold, and it's part of Our Portland Story. And to my immediate right is Melissa Delzio, who's the woman behind the book and the project in general. To her immediate right, Megan Clark. You are an artist who did the visual layout for two of these stories in the book. Two of the essays. The first is about VJ Day, which we touched on earlier. The second is about falling in love in Portland. If you're an outdoors person, this is the best place kind of in the world for you. How were you approached to become part of this?
I actually did the approaching. I saw a post on Craigslist for designers wanting to collaborate in this cool book project, and I thought, oh, why not? And so I responded, and Melissa and I then met, and I got introduced to the project.
It really is, it's a beautiful, the book itself is obviously a piece of art. It's fantastic to look at and to hold and touch, and it's just got a great sense to it of aesthetic all the way through it. The other fascinating thing about the book is that while it hits some of the primary highlights of Portland, the things that people think of, it also talks about specific restaurants and streets, some of which don't exist anymore. Mm-hmm. It's sort of equal parts yearbook and nostalgia trip and tour guide. It's quite unlike anything I've ever seen. This must sell really strongly to people who used to live here and don't anymore.
Yeah, I actually have some clients who have moved away, and I'm dying to send them one so that they can have a little piece of home, because they crave it. They miss it a lot.
What has been the reaction of people in Portland to the book when people have seen it for the first time?
We had a launch party at Mississippi Studios, like I said, and we had, I think, about 200 people, a little over 200 people show up. And a lot of them were contributors, designers, and authors, and then they all brought their family and guests, and we had readings, and Megan came, and, you know, a lot of the designers and authors hadn't met, and so I was using that event to try to, you know, match up the designers and the authors so they could meet each other for the first time.
That's interesting. So you had approached Melissa, and you said, I saw this ad, and mm-hmm. this posting, I want to be part of the project.
Yeah.
How did you then decide what artist and what story were matched up?
I did ads on Craigslist, and I have a network of designers, so I kind of was gathering portfolios, and when someone would, like Megan would respond to a post, I would review the portfolio and look at their aesthetic, and oh, they're really strong typography, or a really strong illustrator, or whatever their strengths were, and then I would look at the stories and try to match, you know, oh, like this page, for example, really required an illustrator. They didn't really provide any imagery. And so then I matched that story with an amazing illustrator. So there was a lot of that matchmaking. Also interests, like some designers were all about sports, like they do work for the Blazers, and that's their forte is, and so then I matched them with a story that was, you know, at sports nature. It was about dodgeball. And
what was your first step in designing the layout for those essays? I wouldn't even know how to begin.
Yeah, like sometimes I don't either. No, I think in any design project is always research, so spending some real time with the story, visualizing what actually happened through the story, and then, I don't know, kind of doing some visual research and figuring out what sort of things might represent the things I felt and the emotions that were expressed in the story, and then going on from there and just layering in type and photos and all of that. So
you mentioned something during the break actually that I want to bring up here, and I want to make sure that I get this correctly. If someone who resides within the Portland city limits orders the book, they have the option of having you deliver it
by bike.
So you actually bike to their house or to their wherever the book's being delivered?
Yes.
And just sort of and present them with the book.
That's the theory. So if you order online and put Portland bike delivery, in your under the city name. Then, if, as long as you live within a reasonable distance to my house, which is not so much the outer portions of Portland, but yeah, you know, me or my boyfriend or a combination of the two of us will bike deliver the book, and we'll even refund your shipping.
So it's our Portland story, and it's our Portland delivery, so long as it does not overly tax your ability to.
Yes.
In terms of the book and the way that you put it together and the way you assembled it, did you deliberately pick a specific a proportion of stories that were about things that were contemporary and a number of stories from the past? Did you?
Yeah. I mean, it kind of just naturally occurred that way. Like I said, I got a really diverse range of submissions, which was not what I was expecting. I actually, when I started the project, I thought, oh, well, there'll be a section that maybe is about restaurants and a section that's about nature and a section that's about beer. I don't know. I thought I would sort of divide it that way. But then the submissions I got were completely all over the board and too random to even categorize.
Megan, when you saw the posting for this, how much detail was in the posting about the project itself? What did you know about it when you responded?
I don't think there was a lot in the posting itself, but I believe there was a URL.
Yeah, I had
so
a
I went to the Our Portland Story website, and of course there it looked very legitimate and cool, and I got more of a sense of like the overall idea.
Yeah, and I actually sat down with every designer over coffee individually, or sometimes I paired designers up together. And had a creative brief and went over with them what was expected and what sort of, if I had a vision for the page, which most of the time I didn't, the designers really drove it, but yeah.
When we come back, we will talk to an author of one of the essays in this book, which is Our Portland Story. You're watching Outlook Portland right here on Northwest 32 TV. Stay right there.